Straight to the deepest secrets of different bills. Hey, don't put them in, you need it, I got it listed here. You wanna make it, I'll show you just how to make it here. I got all the rarest bills, and I ain't done yet. Move from defenders to making bills like a prospect. Flow space and slashes to catching us with a law threat. You keep the medals, cause the realm is coming up next. Only scratch the surface, still they try to drag my name in dirt. They try to bring me down, see me winning, you ain't like me.
Yo, what's good, my nephews and nieces? This is your favorite uncle, Uncle Demi, and today I have another special banger for you. Right now, listen, before we get too far in the video, you know exactly what you need to do. Make sure you drop a like, and let's get this video to at least 1,000 likes, okay? That would definitely push the video to the recommended. And furthermore, if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe. You already know I'm the hardest working YouTuber in the 2K community, and hopefully you can appreciate that 9 a.m. and that 4 p.m. upload every single day, and you can show that appreciation by dropping a like and subscribing. All right, now listen, today we are going to talk about the skilled glass cleaner, basically a glass cleaner that's skilled, man. So it's not that much different than what you would say with a playmaking glass cleaner would be. It's just that obviously the playmaking is a little bit higher, but I love this name. Obviously this is a new name, new build that has been brought into the next gen, and again, you know I love just new builds, and obviously this has been long overdue to bring in some more new names. But the skill glass cleaner I'm going with is going to be 6'7", all right? It's going to be 243 pounds, and then I'm going to have a 7'3" wingspan. So it's not going to be the max wingspan, it's going to be one tick below, okay? And then body type, as usual, it doesn't really matter, okay? And then what I decided to do again is go with the 88 driving dunk, an 86 driving layup, and then post control 72. Okay, that would get you at 8. Actually, you can go a little lower. Okay, 70. Let's go 70 at post control to get 8. That's the only reason why. If you do standing dunk, it turns into a slashing playmaker, and that's what's been frustrating, because you know I love the standing dunk, but I'm not able to do the standing dunk here. Okay, you could go 82 here, but I just went 81. I mean 81 to each one, to get 85 for both, and then a decent free throw, which again with the +4 will get you a 71, so you'll be able to shoot free throws well if you're a rec player. And then the pass accuracy, we're going 79. Ball handling, we're going 81, and then speed with ball, we're maxing out to 81 also, okay? And then interior defense, again, how important interior defense is, we're going 70 on interior defense, we're going 86 on the perimeter, we're going 71 on steal, we're going on block, we're going 82 on the block, and then we're going 86 on the defensive rebound, and then 79 on the offensive rebound. And of course, we're gonna max out the speed, the acceleration. Strength, we're gonna go to a 70. Vert, we're going to a 70. And then stamina, we're going to a 62. Well, we actually can go here, let's do this. Let's go 71 on that vert, let's get out there. You know, we only need 60 stamina, man. You don't need anything higher than that. So you can go there. And then actually we can go 89 here. All right, bet. So there we go. So we'll max it out like that. Okay, so 8, 12, 19, and 16. And as you remember, just like the playmaking glass cleaner from before, remember playmaking glass cleaner before only had like one or two finishing. So this one actually has more finishing and a ton more shooting, which is pretty dope. We have a little less playmaking and defensive rebound, but again, that's just so we can get some of this up here taken care of. But 8, 12, 19, 16 is good. But then when you look at the attributes of these builds, as you see right here, you get a +4 to everything. So a 93 driving dunk is going to be really good. A 90 driving layup, 85 mid-range and three-point shot. That's the reason why I wanted to do that, because obviously the 85 gives you a pure green window. So if you have the proper base, you'll be able to green every single time you get a good release on your jump shot, which is very important. If you wanted to go here, you can do that too. If you want to get like, you know, if you wanted to wait less to get it, in this instance, you have to be a 99 overall. But it's really your call. 83 pass accuracy, 85 ball handle, 85 speed with ball. Of course, we all know the importance of 81 speed with ball with a power forward position. That means you get quick first step Hall of Fame, which is kind of crazy to think about. You only need an 81 speed with ball as a power forward, you can get that, but you need to be a 90 something at the point guard position to get it. 74 interior defense, a 90 perimeter defense, which again is associated with your lateral quickness. So if you didn't know that, and also if you didn't know, for my nephews and nieces, mid-range and post fade is also associated with each other. So I don't know if I ever mentioned that, but your post fade and your mid-range shot is the same. They're associated together. You get a 75 steal, 86 block, 84, 83 offensive rebound, and a 90 defensive. 86 speed, 82 acceleration, 74 strength, 75 vert, and of course 64 stamina, which is not that important. But yeah, that's what we're looking at here. Now, when we come here to the takeovers, we do have slashing, we have shooting, we have playmaking, and we have lock. And then we all know what the best way to go with it is the easy blow bys, enhanced ability to get by your defenders, and then the limitless range threes. That is a good combination, obviously, because there's no way you can guard this. If you play up too close, I'm gonna blow by you. If you play off too far, I have the limitless range three to shoot the three. It's pretty unstoppable to guard when you think about it. So again, that is the best combination. If you have that combination, that's the one I always recommend going with, okay? And then here you have it, my nephews and nieces, the skilled glass cleaner, all right? So what we're gonna do is this. We're gonna go ahead and test this build out real quick, get the 99, and then we're going to get you out of here, right? So we only have 8 finishing badges to work with, but that doesn't stop me from wanting to go posterizer on Hall of Fame. You always wanna do posterizer Hall of Fame. You also wanna get slithery finisher. So we get slithery finisher on silver, and then we top it off with acrobat. I know a lot of people sleep on acrobat, but I just see myself missing more and more reverse layups without this. So I always just try to go silver on that, because sometimes if I don't do reverse dunk, this comes up and I just need to have something, because I'm tired of missing reverse layups. It's annoying. All right. So that's what I'm going with. And in here on the shooting, we all know what you need to do. Blinders, deep threes, hot zone hunter, and then you can go catch and shoot if you're not the primary ball handler. If you are the primary ball handler, then either stop or pop or rhythm shooter. Just depends on how you play. Me, I am definitely more of a rhythm shooter guy. So I go rhythm shooter, which improves your shot taking after breaking down your fender, which is basically mean just like you know, do either a curry behind the back or do a couple between the legs and then shoot, right? Usually behind a pick and roll. Stop and pop is really good too. That's just basically, as it says, boost shots rating on standstill three-pointers after dribbling. So, you know, you catch the ball, do a curry slide, run to the corner, stop, shoot, that pops up. It's just different play styles, but I'm not really big on quick stopping, so I just don't do that. Playmaking, of course, you want to go handles for days. Quick first step, if you're going to be the primary ball handler, this is what you will want, right? And then, of course, you want to get ankle breaker. You definitely want to get a space creator, and you want to get bullet passer a little bit too, but not going to be able to do that unless we go something like that. I don't know. Still call on these guys. Clamps, of course, chase down for the animation. We know the most important stuff, Intimidator, Rim Protector. These are the most important badges. Intimidator and Rim Protector, you got to max it out. That's just is what it is. There's no way around it. You got to max it all the way out. And then I'll go something like this. All right, so this is what I would go with. All right. But anywho, there you have it, my nephews and nieces. This is the skilled glass cleaner build. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you drop a like, subscribe to the channel. And as usual, your favorite old head, Uncle Demi. I'll be back really, really soon with the banger, man. You know, when I say back soon with the banger, you already know damn I'm talking about. I'm talking about tomorrow, man. I'm out.